will talk about how to see aspect of homological mirror symmetry. And in particular, this talk is going to be elementary, as you can see. I will first recall the Hodge decomposition. So if we're given a complex manifold, we can use the complex structure to decompose the DRAM complex over C. So you just decompose respect to PQ type of this form, where here F is some complex value function. Then if you do this for Kähler manifold, the Hodge theory will tell you this decomposition will survive in homology, so you will get the Hodge decomposition in homology, where HPQ is the homology of this PQ type differential forms, and you can show it's isomorphic to P's cohomology, P's double cohomology with a value in the vector bundle or holomorphic Q forms. So in particular, you should this decomposition is also dependent on a complex structure. I would like to talk about the Hodge DRAM spectral sequence and its degeneration. So you see by the previous slide, and you can decompose your exterior differential into del and del bar, and then there is a double complex you can consider. And if your x is Kähler, the associated spectral sequence will just degenerate at E1, and it converges to the DRAM cohomology of X. And in characteristic zero, you can prove this E1 degeneration from Hodge theory for Kähler manifold, or alternatively, there's a proof by Professor Delin and Yilu Zi. They use some method to reduce to finite characteristic. As you can see on E1 page, if you actually compute this spectral sequence, E1 PQ will just be identified with the pieces for the Hodge decomposition. And here, really, E1 degeneration will tell you that, will imply the Hodge decomposition for H K of X in C. Also, this is, in fact, something much more powerful. This is called some pure Hodge structure of weight K. I wouldn't go into the detail of this. There are many people have studied this theory. The upshot here is this is a very powerful theory for distinguish, for example, complex algebraic variety. Talk about something about mirror symmetry. So just recall, Calabi-Yau is just a complex manifold with this canonical bundle trivial. So in particular, it means that there is a non-zero holomorphic volume form. So the first instance of mirror symmetry is discovered for Calabi-Yau threefolds. Let's denote them as X and S check. So in 1990, Green and Plaster, their physicists first constructed a mirror for the quintuplet threefold in P4. Later, Kandelak, Sadella, Osa, Green, and Parkers predicted the generic zero Gromov-Witten invariant of X can be using the period integrals on the mirror X check. So I will now tell you what these invariants are, but the point of this shows that the genus zero Gromov-Witten invariant, which is something purely dependent on the symplectic or the Kähler form of X, can be actually recovered using some period integral, which is purely dependent on the complex structure. So this is where mirror symmetry lies in. Very simple. So what does Hodge theory say about mirror pairs? If you denote this, you look at the rank of the PQ groups over C, you will see that, for the quintic, you have a rotation of Hodge diamond like this. Okay? So in this case, mirror symmetry is really just a simple case of rotation of 90-degree Hodge diamonds. So later, there are more development for mirror symmetry. Mathematically, one of the formulation is called homological mirror symmetry. That's the part I'm interested in. So, So let's say we are given a symplectic manifold, well, X and a complex manifold X check. Well, in this case, I'm assuming they're both collabial. Then there are two categories. One is the chi category of X. The objects will be Lagrangian manifold, submanifolds. The morphism group will be a floral homology group, or cohomology group in this case, which have been talked about. As a abelian group is just generated by the intersection of L1 and L, L0 and L1. And on the other hand, you have a category of Cauchyan sheaves, and let's just take its morphism to be the X group of two Cauchyan sheaves. So in 1994, Maxim Kimsevich proposed the following homological mirror symmetry conjecture, which says that for two collabial mirror pairs, there are derived equivalence between the Foucault category of X and the category on coherent sheaves of X check, and actually vice versa. So one of the questions. Oh, no. So here is for collabials. So it has both, they're Kähler, so. Yeah, sure, but in general, I want to think about in this setting. Okay, so the leading question here is that can we use the homological mirror symmetry to transfer the well-known study of Hodge theory from the complex side to the symplectic side? Certainly, I mean, your question is valid, like, sometimes I don't really have a complex structure, or it's purely symplectic, but can we still do this? Okay, and to do this, since here we're saying that categorically or homologically, these two categories really look the same. So if we can derive a Hodge theory for category, maybe we can just apply to categories, and it works all at once. Okay, so this is not my idea. So instead of the usual Hodge 2D RAM, let's talk about the non-commutative Hodge 2D RAM spectral sequence. So this, given a associative algebra, the Hodge homology, which appeared in Dimitri's talk, actually has two differentials. One is the Hodge differential, one is the Kahn's differential constructed by Alan Kahn's. In particular, these two differentials also anti-commute, which you see that it appear to be a lot like del and del bar. And in fact, you can, if you denote the homology of this Hausdorff chain with respect to the first differential as this Hausdorff homology, but then you have a next differential. These two forms a double complex. The homology of the double complex I would denote as HC of A. This is called a cyclic homology of the associative algebra. Here I added some formal variable just purely because in this case the two operators doesn't have the same degree. One is raising degree by one, one is decreasing degree by one. So if you want to get a differential, you have to add in some formal variable. But the result is this double complex that you can see. So let's just say if A is just even a coordinate ring of a smooth affine variety, which is commutative, what do you get? Then the famous Hausdorff-Kostin-Rosenberg theorem says that if you take the Hausdorff homology of this coordinate ring, you will just get back to the Dirac differential forms, which you should think that they're the replacement for differential forms for you. And even more, if you apply this isomorphism here, you will just map this chain complex, Hausdorff chains with this Kahn's operator to the Dirac differential, Dirac complex with its usual Dirac differential. This is, shown by Kahn's or a paper of Quillen and Loday, which is very old. So the upshot is that these things are non So then if you don't have commutative rings, you have associative algebra or even differential graded categories, you can start to use this Hausdorff homology or CK homology to replace your original definition. So in this case, you can replace the original Hausdorff derived spectral sequence by the so-called Hausdorff to CK spectral sequence. Okay, so then once you have this, you can start to do Hodge theory on categories. So I will tell you some of the previous study on Hodge theory, that aspect of mirror symmetry. So if given a category which is, so I will assume it's a differential graded category which is smooth and proper, here you can really just take a categorical coherent sheaf of a projective variety. It will satisfy all my assumption. And essential term here is that this category is proper, which means that if I look at its Hom space, it has finite homological dimension. So if I pass homology, I get finite vector spaces. So in this situation, Branikov, Kansevich, Karzakov, and Pantev have developed a non-commutative version of Hodge theory for this category. While assuming, so actually their work assuming the E1 degeneration of this non-commutative Hodge to derived spectral sequence. But in just this year, 2016, Kaladin has already proved the degeneration for this non-commutative Hodge to derived spectral sequence for smooth and DJ category. So now you can start to apply their theorem. And there's also a recent work by Ganatra, Putz, and Sheridan in 2015, which used this tool applied to the categorical coherent sheaves or Foucault category in this case for Calabi-Yau's. And the result of this is they can, in particular, recover the enumerative mirror symmetry for the quintic, by which I mean that you can really recover the genus zero Gomovitan count through the homological mirror symmetry and apply that. Okay. So my talk or what I'm interested in is actually mirror symmetry for open manifold instead of closed manifold that I have been talking about. So in this case, I won't even tell you what's the category. I will just give you a prototype. I want to think about the simplest example, which is a mirror pair of C star, and its mirror is also C star. One problem is that, so now C star is a non-compact space variety. If you consider compactly supported coherent sheaves in the category, then the only object you will get is just Scapps Kuiper shift at points. So now it's natural to consider coherent shifts with non-compact supports. But for example, we can take the structure shift of C star. But the problem is that now you arrive at the problem that the morphism space, if you take X group past homology, this is some infinite dimensional space over C, and which, by the way, also appeared in Heather's talk, that you can also compute this on the mirror, you get the same thing. So in this case, in order for homological mirror symmetry to hold, you want the version of the Foucault category which is positive non-proper. That means possibly the Hom space have infinite dimensional homological dimension. So this is the Rapkai category defined by Abzai and Seidel. So they only sorry, maybe I shouldn't say this before. So now I want to actually apply this Hodge theory for DJ category story, but since this since this category might be non-proper or space, the mirror space itself is some non-open open manifold word. So the only Hodge theory Hodge structure I know of is in this work of Professor Dilling that for an open manifold that it's a complement of smooth normal crossing divisor, you can actually construct the mixed Hodge structure from the from a spectral sequence that's arriving when you compute this hyperconhomology of X with value in the logarithm differential forms of X respect to this normal crossing divisor. So so the questions I would like to study now is that so if I look at the how to derive spectral sequence for the wrap sky category, when does it degenerate? Well, this question is somehow simpler, but if the wrap sky category is proper, in some cases it is, but in many cases it's not. I have been recently thinking about this question. And they're still in working progress, so if you're interested, you can ask me. But further question would be that, so if it doesn't degenerate at E1, maybe it degenerate at E2 and so on. And also if you don't have to, so there's some notion of, it's called a non-degenerate Liouville manifold, M. So in this case, you can actually identify the Hausdorff homology of a rough category with symplectic homology, and on the other side, the cyclic homology of rough category with the equivariant symplectic homology of M by the work of Ganatra. Then, for example, even in the case that your rough category is proper, your spectral sequence should degenerate by colliding. What kind of Hodge filtration or structure you can get on the resulting cyclic homology using that. So, but all these groups or the rough category itself is a invariant of the Liouville manifold. So it's a purely symplectic construction. So these filtration I would expect, they are symplectic invariants. So you can ask, for example, if you have a symplectic morphism, or are they respect the resulting filtration? That would be all.